everybody! Meow! I kind of mentioned making these in the tutorial I made for the ears, and I thought since I absolutely had to have a pair for myself, I figured I would share what I did to make these with you guys. If you haven't already watched the Superhero Gauntlet tutorial, you have to watch that one first because that's what these are based on. And there is a slight change that I will talk about in the little tutorial, but this is primarily about how to make the paw prints for your little kitty cat fingerless gloves. So without further ado, let's head to the table and make ourselves a cute little purring pair of gloves to match our ears. Meow. All right, this tutorial is going to focus primarily on the paw print. Here are some notes on how to make the fingerless gloves. Watch the Superhero Gauntlet tutorial. Make each glove exactly the same way up until the row just above the thumb opening, or what I call the decrease row. And instead of snipping your yarn and fastening off, just do three more rows in straight half double crochet, no increasing, no decreasing, and then finish off with a row of single crochet around the top and then fasten off. And that will just give you a nice straight across fingerless glove. Now, we're going to make six of the little toe prints and two of the little paw, the little paw pad. So that's what it's going to look like when it's done. We're going to start with the little toe prints, and we're going to take our pink. And I'm using the same pink and black yarn that I used to make the cat ears headband. So worsted weight in pink and black. This is Red Heart Comfort, and this is just sort of some extra pink I had lying around. I'm using a 4.25 millimeter hook. Got my scissors and my yarn needle. We're going to start with a cinch circle, and we're making the little toe prints. So after we've made our cinch circle, we're going to single crochet eight into the circle. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And I always single crochet over top of my tails when I'm making cinch circles, just because when you cinch it shut, it just pulls everything together a little more neatly. So then you're going to finish off with a slip stitch. So you're going to insert your hook in that first single crochet, wrap your yarn, pull it back through everything, and then you're going to fasten off, and you're going to leave enough yarn that you can sew the little toe pad or the little toe print to the underside of your glove. And you just fasten off. Now, you're going to go ahead and make six of these, three for each glove. All right, I have made three of my little toe prints. So that's these little guys right here. Boom, boom, boom. And now, I'll just put these to the side. Now we're gonna make the middle print or the pad. So, still with the same yarn, same hook. We're gonna make a cinch circle, and we're gonna start exactly as we did for the toe print. So we're going to make a cinch circle, and into that circle, we're going to single crochet eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, let me cinch it shut a little bit, seven, and eight. Cinch it shut. Now we're not going to join with a slip stitch. We're just going to continue working into the very next stitch. And I'm going to work over my short tail because I like to weave things in as I go. So here we go. Into the next stitch, or the first one you created of row one, if you can get your hook in there, there we go, you're going to single crochet twice. One, two. You're going to single crochet twice into the next stitch. One, two. Into the next stitch, we're going to half double crochet two times. And we're going to half double crochet two times into the next stitch. Into the next two stitches, so one, two, we're going to single crochet twice. One, two. One, two. And into the last two single crochet, or the last two stitches there, the last two stitches of the first row, we're going to half double crochet two times. So you're going to, row two consists of two single crochet, two single crochet, two half double crochet, two half double crochet, two single crochet, two single crochet, and two half double crochet, two half double crochet. That gives you a complete total of 16 stitches all the way around for row two. Row three, we are just going to single crochet, but we're going to continue to increase our stitches. So into the next stitch, we're going to single crochet two times. One, two, single crochet into the next stitch, one, and single crochet two times into the next stitch, one, two, once into the next stitch, and you're going to repeat this pattern of two single crochet, one single crochet, two single crochet, one single crochet, all the way around until you have a total of 24 stitches. Fasten off by slip stitching into the next stitch. And remember to leave a nice long bit of string because you're going to sew, so just fasten off here, you're going to sew your paw print with that yarn and your yarn needle to the underside of your gauntlet or your fingerless glove. Take your fingerless glove and you're going to identify, so this is my left glove, and you're going to identify it by the seam. So the seam that you created every time you finished a row, that's your underside. And this is the side we're going to actually put the paw print on. It's really, really simple. You just lay out all your pieces and you can put these anywhere you want. I put mine closer to the top. You just lay out all your pieces, just like that. And I want to make sure that mine both match. There we go. And now I'm going to begin sewing with the middle paw print. So I'll take these three guys off. I'm going to hold it in place with my thumb. There we go. And I'm going to pick up the top of the stitches across the fingerless glove, much the same way that I did when I was putting the inner ears sewn into place on the outer ears in the cat ear headband tutorial. Now, if you go all the way through your stitches to the other side, it doesn't really matter because the other side of this fabric is the inside of your fingerless glove and no one is going to see that. So just zip your way around the edge, picking up stitches and sewing it down into place. And once you get a few stitches down, you're not going to have to worry about holding it in place as much because it's going to stay in place. And just continue to work your way around until you've got the whole thing sewn down. I'm just putting in the last stitch here. And all I'm going to do is put a little tiny knot. I'm going to pick up one of the first little stitches I put in. I'm just going to put in a little tiny knot. There we go. And I'm going to tuck this in just weave in the edges a little bit. Don't have to do the whole thing. go. That's enough. Trim my excess. And now I'm going to start with the toe prints. I'm going to bring the three of them back. I'm just going to lay them out again where I want to put them. And I'm going to start by sewing on the middle one. Yeah, it looks pretty good. So I'll take the two side ones away. Make sure that this is pretty much equal to the other one. So it's right in the middle. And I'm going to grab my yarn needle. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing I did for the paw pad. I'm just going to keep my thumb on it for the first few stitches. And I'm going to just pick up stitches across the top. I'm going to weave that in later. And I'm just going to work my way around. There we go. Till the whole thing is successfully sewn down. Just putting in the last stitch. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing I did for the pad. I'm just running out a little bit of yarn here. I'm just going to put a simple little knot in place. There we go. And then I'm just going to weave it in. I'll stick it in through a few stitches just to sort of lock it in place. There we go. I'm going to trim off the excess, and then I'm going to move to the next two, and I'm going to sew the next two toe prints on exactly the same way I did the first one. And there you go, two paw prints, and on they look something like that. See, simple and fun, and you can make a pair for yourself and anybody else, you know, as long as you know how big to make them. Fingerless gloves are great this time of year because the temperature kind of cools differently in different regions. I know that it's gotten really cool here, and I know that it is cooling in other parts around the world as we speak. These are also really fun if you want to wear a pair of little stretchy gloves underneath them and you can extend their season. They're good if you work in a cool building, if you type a lot. They're great for texting because your fingers are free. So keep fingerless gloves in mind as a gift for anybody you know too as we head into the gift-giving season, because these are great and a lot of fun and people would totally appreciate getting a pair. I know I would. I will talk to you guys again very soon as we head into the season of fun and making, and stay tuned. We've got lots of stuff on the way. Please like and subscribe. Please share with your friends, and we will see you again very shortly to stitch up something else. Bye, guys!